With Kingdom Rush Vengeance being out on Steam for a few weeks now, I thought it would only be appropriate to attempt the manliest challenge, one I am sure any Chad has thought about doing when playing these games, but not dared attempting. This is where I come in, a handsome and delusional young lad ready to waste precious time and brain cells in the name of science. Today, we ask the question, can you beat Kingdom Rush Vengeance with only Barracks? Surely, a game centered around strategically planning out your every move can't be beaten by backseat gaming so much that you spam the supporting tower everywhere. Well, let's find out. For this one, we are going to start a fresh game. Now, I have always longed to see what was under that shade of Vesnans. However, I think he took shade too literal when I was hit with an even better sight. God damn! His body with deadly features was perfect, beautifully figured, and ready to fuck. However, Vesnan had more important business to attend to, but my simping and insistence got me appointed to his first general in command of his pay slaves. While I don't know why he would do such a thing, since my strategic ability was equivalent to 11-year-old me playing the 2011 debut for the first time, but I wasn't complaining. To begin this erotic conquest, we first had to purge his hometown from the sinners. Technically, I failed the challenge already, as this game babysits and forces you to build an archer tower in the beginning of this game, but this is just a tutorial level, and it's not even considered part of the main campaign as it doesn't have a number. Maybe this was a warning from the developers to protect me from self-harm, but I was not going to let this get in the way of my patriotic belief. And in my heart, I am sure that this is how the absolute legends at Ironhide headquarters imagined this game to be played. With this level finished without a hassle and the man cave saved, I now had an ego that rivaled the Himalayas and I was ready to go. So let's quickly establish some rules. The only towers I can build are barracks. If I even lay a brick down for something that is not a barrack, I will be immediately disqualified. Rule 2. No premium heroes or towers will be allowed this run, as that would make things too easy. These three heroes and towers will therefore be the only ones I can use this run. Rule 3. If it was not obvious how completely out of my mind I am, then we are going to be playing on veteran, as impossible is probably literally impossible with these dumbfounded rules. Rule 4. When I say completing the game, I mean beating the main campaign. The extra stages, however, well, I may be an idiot, but I'm not stupid. Besides, the credits roll when you defeat King Dennis, so after level 16, we will consider it a victory Royale. Added bonus rule, if you end up enjoying this video, then make sure to soul burn that like button. Thank you. You're looking fine as fuck today, by the way. With barracks having no range, with the exception of the sexual harassers, then flying enemies and possibly bosses are going to be our doom this run. The main objective is to get a hold of the dick-punching madness that is these elves. However, we first unlock them in the third act of the game, meaning that we are in for a menu of a hot spanking special with extra pain and a Diet Coke thrown on top. Anyway, the beginning of Lynira's transition into a dictatorship went all dandy. I beat the first two levels with my toy soldier collection. The first try, I didn't even lose any lives. However, this was just a warm-up for what awaited me in level 3. This level was home of the flying go-karts. My only method of damaging them was Varric's ult, but I had an ace up my sleeve.
Tridents, baby.
This upgrade gives your reinforcements a ranged ability. While the damage is minimal, this was my only hope of making it through this one alive. A couple tries in, and the flying dwarves ruined my day. Did you know what was just as bad, however? These fucking guys, with their cannons and giant balls, they would pick on my army from afar. About 4 attempts in, I now realized that I had to change up my strat. But these guys did less damage to the flying fucks than a what are those burn in 2020. So I spent my extracted souls on lowering the cooldown on Varric's ult instead, because these spearmen was like kryptonite to these air force attack helicopters. With a measly 2 lives left, I was able to make it through. With the burning trident's upgrade now in my possession, I was ready for the next serving of spanking in level 4. But I was pleasantly surprised. With the burning forks, the flying enemies were not a problem anymore. I was making it through the waves of scum without error. Or that was until I encountered the new kid on the block. These stoned dudes were here just to twist my nipples. With their insecurity, these guys will take a fat load of steroids, tripling their health when they come into human contact, forcing you to be strategic about where you place your barracks. And, well, I'm fucked. Goddamn, to say this was hard was a big understatement. My third attempt, I was fortunate enough to make it to the last wave, which decided to end my life by spawning in drones.
Fuck, you cannot be serious. You cannot be serious. You cannot be serious.
Oh my god, you cannot be fucking serious.
I must have ordered from Amazon, cause they flew straight to my home. After spending almost 2 hours on this, doing the equivalent of banging my head through a wall, I was able to develop a tactic. If I by some miracle could make it to wave 15 without going below 10 lives, I could let a few of the flying go-karts pass without dying. This was big, cause that meant I could send more troops to prevent the cancer cluster from spreading down here. After this victory, I now realized that the Bible had been lying to me all along, cause this girl was my messiah. With her range and my delusion, surely this run was about to get easier. A bodybuilder was sent to ruin my run. However, that is where my new hero comes into play, because her ability to forcefully make enemies eat a tight part practically rendered this fool a goner. I was feeling some type of way. Not even the flying enemies were a problem with this e-girl. That was of course until this level decided to unload on me in the last waves. But hey, you had me in the first half. This was practically the previous level back for round 2. Stone dudes and now bodybuilders made this into a huge fuckfest. The thought of unlocking a new barrack afterwards were the only thing that kept me going. And in the end, I pulled through. And I believe that it was now time for my first boss. Before that, however, I first had to disarm another batch of my entire screen filling up with enemies. But I now had damage. These guys were putting in work. Straight up, ripping and tearing dwarf ass. A hot little moment later and I had made it to the boss. Not gonna lie, this fight had me shitting green pigs. Because I had absolutely no idea how to deal with this guy one-shotting my troops. I was just swinging it and hoped I would make it out on top. But it turned out that this spot was able to pile so many goons up, locking him in place. And now it was simply a matter of waiting out the cooldowns on my abilities and blasting his ass back to Tilted Towers. With flawless gameplay across the board, I was able to beat him my first try. Before making my way to the fat cunt known as King Dennis, a skiing trip to the mountains was needed. These lands were inhabited by inbreds and vile mouth breeders. These savage people were completely cut off from society. So therefore, I thought it was justified to exterminate them all on the spot. It was all fun and games until they decided to send way beefier flying enemies my way. Some luck was needed to get past this encounter. I literally lost while fighting the last 10 enemies in the stage.
Ah shit. No, 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 come on. That's not fair, guys. Come on. It was the very last enemies. Oh, come on. Oh, that...
After unfucking my ass after that one, I threw myself at them again. However, I now realized that a special tower was placed here in my honor. And this thing classified as a barrack. The frosty popsicle axe-throwing trolls were going to be my salvation. And even after playing it a little sloppy, they were able to carry me through. A salute for their broad-mindedness are welcome. To tell you the truth, with the first level of the second act not giving me a break, I was scared for what was in store for me and the rest of it. I at least thought that the next level was going to give me a breather.
Wrong. Bad.
This level went full-blown Mike Tyson wombo combo on my fragile little fiddlesticks type of body. The aerodactyls came in at the most inconvenient of times. This is also the level where these frosty fox sticks are introduced. These vile creatures will stand in the backline and keep spawning in little jimmies, insisting on getting the attention that their parents never gave them. On paper, this doesn't seem so bad if you just make sure to send some reinforcements their way. But this isn't very possible when I have a full-scale civil war to take care of down here. An hour and a rage quit later, I had enough of that bullshit and decided that my hero's tide pod attack, reinforcements and portions of condensed toxicity from the League of Legends community was going to be wedded to these blasphemers. It may have been a little overkill, but I will do anything in my power to preserve my rights.
Fuck out of here and go to the
Even with this new strategy, this level was still a giant punch in the sack for me. But persistence is key. According to my maths, if you just literally keep on throwing yourself at something, then eventually it will go your way. And by the I don't have a clue as to how I did it method, I succeeded. Moving on to the next one, I assumed the worst. But to my surprise, this wasn't too bad. Yeah, the flying enemies was a giant pain, but this is something we should all be used to at this point. The Valkyries wasn't too bad either. Simply paying attention to when Ezra has her insta-gif ability up will allow you to take a few of them out for free. And then I would just have to beat around around the bush with the rest of them for a bit, waiting for the right opportunity to send them into the slaughter. And this level was pretty much done. Now, I remember this stage bodying me a few times on my first playthrough, so I was scared shitless going into it. This level introduces these guys, who only exist to pound the sole anus of my entire army of BDSM connoisseurs and Fred Flintstones. With their overwhelming chatliness, I thought that I was out of my league here. However, I'll let you in on a little secret. The Dark Knight's vasectomy upgrade. With this upgrade fully erect, there is a 6% chance of them going into the game files and deleting their opponent from the game. It may be an inhumane way of dealing with my problems, but hey, I've seen other people do it too, so that makes it okay. With my nutty gameplay, I was even able to make it past the Valkyrie gangbang without losing any lives. Beating the level my first try. It might have been luck, or maybe my brain was starting to adapt to my autistic ideas. I really don't know. But with faith now restored, I went into the final level of the second episode, slash act. Ingvar Bearclaw's obese brother hit me with some rap battle type beat shit. I ignored his harassment and began digging down his army of hillbillies. Since the second act had been pretty chill so far, with the exception of level 8 of course, I was patiently awaiting the ass clapping I deserved. But it never really happened, because I made it to the boss my first try, baby. This boss fight is simple. You just have to stop the enemies from getting into your DMs while waiting out the cooldowns on your BFGs. You may also have to be prepared to take a few Shrek roars to the face, and goddammit, it seemed like I was not meant to get this. Ingvar Bearclaw 2 had me by the balls. I was destined to lose this round. But with a never before seen last second complete bonkers clutch moment, I was able to put his ass to sleep.
Play of the game.
What the fuck?
With this dub, I now had the harassers in my sights. It was time to bring this fight to Dennis' home turf. This next in the hood prank, gone wrong and also sexual, because this level fucked me over hard, was for some reason the hardest one thus far. Because I was introduced to a new boy toy, who didn't respect my right to illegally skedaddling into his lands to rape and pillage. With a lot of health and armor, these boys spawn in a lot of crap if they aren't dealt with quickly. But this isn't very possible when I have no magic damage. It was time to recruit the homie Olak from my hometown and give him a nice workout. Insert Kung Fu Panda training montage. With Olak now in level 10, nothing really changed, and I still got vote kicked from this stage faster than a Russian kid in a European game. Attempting this was like going to Burger King and attempting to suck up a soda through a paper straw. It was soggy and a disgrace to humanity. No matter my actions, I would lose to either the flying stingers on the block, or the footmen,
or the troop captain,
or the recruits,
or the footmen,
or the watchdog,
or the footmen,
or the recruits,
or the footmen.
You know the drill. Rip and tear until it is done, and after what must have been over 2 hours on this, I would somehow end this suppression. But it was all worth it, because I now had the harassers in my possession. And that meant that this run was close to wrapping up. Getting my shit kicked in for 10 hours straight, had the euphoric experience of placing these down, feeling like cheating. From here on out, every enemy would literally be a test subject for my cock and ball torture inator. For these boys had range. The Luftwaffe bombers weren't even a problem for these men. I would make it through this level with ease. And holy fuck, this next one was annoying. It didn't take me that long to conquer, but goddamn, this level still made sure to serve me a spoonful of hot depravity. These magicians kept on TPing enemies past my men and all up in my shit, which wouldn't be so bad if it wasn't because these golems tried to pound me in also. After spending what must have been 30 minutes trying to kill these remaining golems, I overcame. With level 14 laid to rest, I now knew that it was time for the pseudo boss and face off against Johnny Bravo himself. Before this historic 1v1 on the rift, I would first have to deal with another load of shit being thrown my way. You know, the usual. However, my days were counted now, because this chat had enough of my bullshit. He was here to get revenge for all of those times I favored Malik Hammerfury as my lover over him. Look boys, I'm sorry, but I can't sex all of you. You must understand. But there was no reasoning with Gerald. He wouldn't even listen to my TED talk about how Malik has the biggest man dingo in all of Linera. I really didn't want to fight him. But when he gonna be a fuckboy who doesn't wanna behave, he gonna die like a fuckboy. A good soldier has now passed away this day. While it is not clear what he stood for, he at least died serving his country. Pants off for his bravery. And may he rest on this road, cause I don't have time to bury this guy. With Vesnan's panties now wet, I knew that it was time to show his dad, aka King Dennis, that his business of getting fat at the taxpayer's expense was going to be at a big financial loss. With Vesnan at my assistance, who fortunately brought his homemade slime, I was able to slam dunk on these bureaucrats with style. I won't go into too much detail, because this shit was way easier than coming up with something funny to say here. Fast forward a little bit, and I found myself in the middle of a Pokemon battle between these two. The waifu busted out his fully erect Charizard, and the king thought he was hot shit by bringing out his water-type Blastoise to counter it. However, Visnan doesn't play by the rules. My final Hulk smash tucked his Pokemon in bed, and after approximately 12 hours, it was done. You can beat Kingdom Rush Vengeance with only Barracks. Hey, King Dennis, I have a gift for you.
Yeah, alright, just give him a minute. Trust me on this, guys, the payoff is huge.
In hindsight, this challenge sure gave me a run for my money, but it wasn't as bad as I initially thought. So I might even take me and Vesnan's relationship to the second base by doing the extra campaign stages in a part 2 of this. Comment hashtag part 2 if you wanna make it a reality. Thank you for joining me on this journey and being with me through all of my hardships. Now go and kiss your dad for me and have a wonderful day. I hope I will see you again in the near future.